My project is the Oklahoma City bombing. It was any normal day on April 19th, 1995 in Oklahoma City. That is, until 9:02 a.m., when suddenly the Alfred Murrah Federal Building collapsed. The bomb struck right outside the face of the building. A daycare was on the second floor, right above the blast spot. The nine-story building's floors pancaked on top of one another. A fertilizer bomb planted in a Ryder truck was the cause. This bomb was detonated by Timothy McVeigh. He was executed by lethal injection. There was a great loss of life. 168 people died as a result, and 19 of them were children. After the bombing, America was greatly affected. There were many economic and political effects. One of these was influenced by the Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms Bureau, calling for Congress to develop legislation for customers to show identification when purchasing aluminum nitrate fertilizer. This is the fertilizer that was one of the main ingredients used to build the truck bomb. This also made the sellers take record of all large purchase orders sales. The states of Nevada and South Carolina have taken this in effect. Miss Reese had to say,
the government also put up restrictions on fertilizer types used to make the bombs.
Some companies have made changes to their fertilizer mixers as well. Honeywell, a technology advanced company, developed a nitrogen-based fertilizer which would not blow up on ignition. This can prevent many future tragedies. The government also mandated jersey barriers in front of large public buildings and government buildings. They placed these barriers to help keep cars away from the buildings. At first, many of these were temporary, but the government has spent more on making these barriers permanent and reinforced for better protection. Miss Reese said,
"One thing that I noticed was the cement barriers that went up in front of a lot of government buildings and many buildings in the city."
New requirements also state that all new federal buildings must be a distance away from roadways to help minimize the possibility of car bombings, like Pennsylvania Avenue, and all new federal buildings must now be constructed with truck-resistant barriers. Ms. Reese said,
"After Oklahoma City bombing is when they stopped allowing people to drive Pennsylvania Avenue in front of the White House."
If you haven't noticed, Target, a major superstore, has placed barriers outside their stores. These aren't for decoration, but a measure Target has taken and invested in to protect their customers from another car bombing attack. Monitoring was now present at many places, and people couldn't park on the side of the road next to buildings. Miss Reese said,
"My building, as well as many other buildings and airports, no longer allowed people to pull up and stop in front of the buildings. We also started using ID badges at work, and visitors had to check in with security."
It is shown that the government has spent time and around $6 million in response to defense against another car bombing. As you can see, there are many effects that happen in response to this horrible attack. In all, America was united as one after the attack. We put our arms together and fought through this time of disbelief and loss. We held our heads high and heroes emerged. Timothy McVeigh was put to justice for his horrible crimes. The government has done much to protect the general public with new safety measures and laws. They did this to help prevent another horrific loss of life. The Murrah Building was demolished, and from this emerged a memorial to honor those who lost their lives. However, the effects will last a lifetime. Thank you.